Yes, Hawthorn Hutto, but a really good contest.
That's what we're hoping for tonight. And the Hawthorn are down in numbers in the ruck, so Renouf has to do it all on his own.
Can you hear me?
Show and makers, we can hear you, Rob. Nice to have you with us. As Bateman gets the handball away to Ellis, who is an inclusion tonight. Into the 50 go the Hawks. Already the Swans getting lots of numbers around the ball, putting the pressure on. That was Josh Kennedy, number 32, having a bit of a go at it for Hawthorn. And now they're forward again, and look at that, straight in the lap of Mark Williams, who's going to line up for goal.
And we sort of omit Mark Williams out of the equation sometimes. We talk about Franklin, we talk about Rufford all the time, but he is all quality, Mark Williams. He's such a brilliant third option for him. He gets out on his own and gets a bit of space, and he's a really hard matchup as well.
Started in deep forward.
Didn't kick a goal last week, Mark Williams. That changes very quickly. They've got the opening goal here.
Nice way to start your 100th game. Mark Williams taken pick 43 back in 2000. Twice Hawthorn's leading goal kicker. Game 100 tonight. 25 years of age.
It's interesting at this centre bounce. You've got Roughhead and Franklin up at half forward and three Hawthorn players behind them back near the goals.
Jolly won the tap easily, but it was sharked by Mitchell. Good hands to Renouf, who pumps it out long and wide. Roughhead's got the front posse. Well done by Roberts Thompson, also playing game 100 tonight. What a story he's been, from a rugby background, tutored early by Stephen Silvani.
Massive role tonight for Renouf. I'm not sure who's going to be the second ruckman tonight. Maybe Mitch Thorpe comes in and has to spend some time in the ruck. We've got Robbie Campbell out, so he's going to have to do the bulk of the work tonight, Renouf.
Mitchell again in the clinches, got boot to ball.
It's going to be a beauty, that battle, isn't it, if Mitchell and Kirk go next to each other.
One I'm really looking forward to, Hutto. I reckon Sam Mitchell in the grand final last year would have been really disappointed. Cameron Ling got hold of him. He didn't have much impact. Brett Kirk's the biggest challenge for an elite midfielder. He really want to dominate tonight, Sam Mitchell.
Here's Kennedy. Kick partially smothered. Taken by Rioli. Good kick to Williams for his second. And he slotted it.
Unbelievable way to start for Mark Williams. Two goals in the first 3 minutes. 228 goals in his 100 matches. Mark Williams, of course, he was the key full forward for a while. Now the Swans are going to be able to go into their attacking area for the first time tonight, courtesy of a free kick in the middle. McVeigh receiving the hand pass from Jolly. Well, they still haven't really gone forward yet. Now they can. Matner getting it out. Roberts Thompson. Matner again. Deep. The Hawks have got good numbers back, but trying to stop Hall is going to be a big challenge for Thomas Murphy. We know Zach Dawson did the job last week, but he got a lot of help.
That's a really good sign for the Swans, Luke. Hall gets his hand on it and a clean mark early.
Yeah, and the delivery was a lot better than last week. Came in really nicely to Barry Hall. And one-on-one opportunities. We know how good a player Barry Hall is, and he'll be very, very excited about that.
So Barry Hall averages just over two goals against Hawthorn, which is just below his career average. And that's the sound of the Hawthorn fans behind the goals as Barry misses. He kicked the opening goal last week and then it all dried up for him.
His form up here has been pretty good in the last 11 games. He's averaged three goals. So a fair bit of space. I think it suits him up here.
Guerra does the kicking in. And his kick finds Murphy. And that's a strong grab. Taken by Williams and they're away again to Rioli. Long ball inside 50. Roughhead has to beat three of them. Can't do so. Out of Bolton. Jude. Back to Jolly. He switches. Looking for goods. He lopes after the ball. Little one over the top. Good tackle by Stokes. Throw in centre wing.
And little fellas in the forward line tackling has come into the fore in AFL in recent years. And Cyril Rioli, Stokes, they certainly do it for the Hawks as well as the big fellas.
Good wrestle, but after all that heavy work, Jolly just tapped it straight down to Schoenmakers. Now it sits for Stokes, and Hawthorn could have their third goal on the board. Pretty simple, wasn't it? Coach Walls, you got any issue with him kicking off the ground here?
Well, I think he thought if he picked it up, the tackle would be laid from behind. But I think what that shows you is that Cameron Stokes has got great ball control. He's probably grown up with a footy. And, yeah, wonderful to see. So what a flying start for the Hawks. 3-0.
Mitchell takes it, sends it forward. Mitchell's already damaging with 4 disposals. Reece Shaw committed. It's going to get a free here, I think. No, it's against him.
And I think you'll find, Hutto, the free kick will go to Campbell Brown, really for the courage of putting his body in line there. He's come in. He's got a bit of an elbow to the chin. Shouldn't be a free kick.
Play on.
Yeah, that's a terrible. I mean, you can see what he's paid, so I guess you understand that.
Well, he put himself in a position to get hit, Campbell Brown.
Exactly.
You wouldn't expect anything less, but his old man would be laughing that he got a free for that.
He won't be laughing because he's just missed that shot at goal and he's not too happy about it.
Just shows how keen they are to persevere, well, not persevere, but how important it is in their structure to have Campbell Brown up forward. They've got most of their key defenders out and yet still they want him to play forward, and that's why, because he draws the footy and he draws free kicks.
Matner just finds Paul Bevan.
It's a scrappy start by Sydney, isn't it?
Back to Matner, who provides most of the run. He's caught. Good tackle by Kennedy. Paul Ruse on the blower early. There's the Hawk coach, Alistair Clarkson. Jolly against Renoff. Out the back, Mitchell. Tapped it to Moss, who's playing his second game tonight. Good use of the ball. Finds Morton. Gets it moving quickly to a one-on-one. Rough head. Didn't pay the mark. Roberts Thompson mops up for Sydney, but he puts it out of bounds on the full. Yep. Yes, he does. So it's a free kick to the Hawks,
who bring it in quickly. There's Morton again. And boy, they are pumping it at the moment. Franklin's first chance. Mistimes the leap. Tough down there for Thorpe. Heavy going. Bevan as committed as you would expect. McVeigh, little trigger hand pass. Gets them away. And Shaw's kick onto the wing. O'Keefe got a little nudge out from Whitecross, which was good play. And Hodge sees it over.
I reckon some of the key Sydney forwards, Hutto, will back themselves in. That's Ryan O'Keefe, an All-Australian on young Whitecross. Barry Hall sitting there with Thomas Murphy, who's only played in the vicinity of about 30 games. They would like their chances one-on-one if Sydney can get the footy to them.
Inside 50 at the moment, 8-1 in favour of the Hawks. That's a smashing early in the game as Hodge kicks it back to the wing.
And Hodge was the extra man back in defence there, and that scrambled kick forward by Sydney is just gift wrap for a bloke like Luke Hodge to read it and jump onto it.
Just trying to see where Sydney's next man is, Rob, because it's not in defence.
Another free kick against Renoff, going Jolly's way.
They've manned Hodge up now, up forward, by the look of it.
It's like Craig Bolton's headed his way.
Beautiful kick by McVeigh. In fact, it wasn't in the end, it was out on the full. He found O'Keefe, but
if the boundary line wasn't there, quarters, it was a beautiful kick.
Yeah, fair enough. The boundary line's in a bit tonight too, Robin, isn't it?
Absolutely, quarters. We've been down there many a time over the years, and I think that this ground has shrunk because they've taken the boundary line in.
And a nice mark coming in from the side, taken by Ted Richards. There's Hodge. The general across half-back. Now he's going to switch here. Richards, he goes deep back inside defensive 50 to Bolton. Craig Bolton, who goes to the outer side of the ground. They did that well, the Swans. Marked by Bevan. Now inboard to Shaw, who runs hard from half-back. He pops it up high. That's a tough one for the forwards. Oh, flying high. But no mark was Thorpe. Free kick, and it's going Hawthorne's way for two high.
Had a fair bit of time and space there, Reece Shaw, on that entry, and it just kills you. I mean, Mitch Thorpe went the fly, young player, but if he didn't get it, it was just almost impossible to mark, and you can see Barry Hall, the frustration. He's trying to show some aggression, but got to kick the footy better inside 50 than that.
Whitecross and Moss combined. It was almost a throw. In fact, it wasn't almost a throw. It was a throw against Campbell Brown. And this is Jared Moore, who looked good early last week. Just had the 12 disposals in the end. And they had a number of their key playmakers that were down. Instant play on from Richards and Melcheski, who was all right. And now Reece Shaw had a tight tagging role last week. Might have been freed up a bit this week, which he'll enjoy.
They're one-on-one here now, and if you take your time, Hawthorn will get back. Give him a chance one-on-one, but
didn't kick to the one-on-one, though, did they? There's a free bit of holding. I reckon Barry might have the free.
He's earned himself that free kick. But I reckon it was just when it got to half four, it was an opportunity. Hall was one-on-one, O'Keefe was one-on-one. He's going to play on here, Barry Hall.
And run around, and he's missed again. And they've had a great journey up here so far, the Hawthorn fans behind the goals, and there's plenty of them. And they cheered again when Barry Hall missed. Here's another look at that.
No doubt about the hold. Right idea by Hall, just didn't execute. As Ellis back in the Hawks team, he's one of the many Hawthorn players who had surgery in the off-season. To Brown, to Birchall. Now Young onto that familiar left, and he pumps it long to a one-on-one. Rough head and Roberts Thompson. Oh, almost a mark to Roberts Thompson. Just couldn't quite hang on to it. Now a chance for Rough Head. Fed it out. Here's Kennedy, head down over the football. And he has been pinged. Outnumbered there, young Josh Kennedy, and he's been penalised.
So Kieran Jack had the job on Del Santo last week and wasn't able to quell him. Shaw linking up nicely. Roberts Thompson can run. It is a bit slippery. Remember, the soccer was here during the week with the Socceroos, and the edges of the ground are... There's a free kick to Hawthorn here, and it won't be 50. Sydney had kicked a goal, or Ryan O'Keefe thought he'd kicked a goal, but he's been penalised. Let's have a look. Hands in the back.
Against Meredith, the first gamer.
Yeah, it's a pity because for O'Keefe, because he took the mark and would have got a free kick himself, but no wonder he thought he was free to go and kick the goal.
Well, no, technically that's a free kick, Hutto, but I don't like it at all. It's so soft.
How good's the kick by Dew?
Well, the kicking is such a feature, isn't it? And Dew last week was another... I think it was 11 Hawthorn players to only have 10 possessions or less last week, which is amazing when you consider how close they came to Geelong. Dew was one of them, but gee, did some damage with two goals. Speaking of damage, this man can inflict more than most. On this occasion, though, Hodges' kick is poor, and it's chopped off by Goods, who's got Ablett away, and Bird running for him on the wing.
Poorly directed kick again. Was it off the foot?
They're battling, aren't they, Sydney, with their ball movement.
This is the hands in the back against... not much in that,
Meredith,
is there?
Yeah.
I mean, against Meredith. It just seems very, very soft, that.
Well, the ball came off the foot of Whitecross, so it's a free kick to the Swans.
Aren't you on the rules committee?
Yes.
Inside 50's 10-3 in favour of the Hawks. Roberts Thompson kicks to Richards. There's no one in one half of the ground now. Huge numbers back for the Hawks. Matner kicks to the pocket. That's out on the full. Another bad kick by Sydney.
It's the kick into the 50 that counts. They've had six passes across the wing into their back line, Sydney, but it's the one into the 50 that counts, and Matner just blew it.
Ellis to Birchall. Not much on, so he goes back, and he finds Young. Got Hodge loose. And now Hodge can go. He's got about 25 metres, just props, and he kicks to Kennedy. He's had a bit of the ball early. Kicks to Bateman, and that's a terrific diving mark by Chance Bateman. Now to Roughhead, attacks it. Good effort by Richards to create the contest. That was well done. Running back into the hole, and a stalemate here. Umpire lets it go, now we'll have a bounce. Good stuff from Richards.
Yeah, it was a great effort, Cordes. You called it really well. It was brave. Here's the mark from Bateman too. Speaking of good efforts, that is sensational. He's a great player, Chance Bateman, but Richards, he knew he was backing back into trouble, and that's what Sydney have been renowned for.
Jude Bolton, disorientated, had to go along the line. Bevan, Bird, good running from White. Crouch is there with him as well. Goes longer again. They're outnumbered, though, the Swans.
Yeah.
That's easy pickings.
And just typical of Hawthorn, getting the extra numbers back, particularly that fella there, Luke Hodge.
Brett Kirk, no disposals yet. He's trying to lock down on Sam Mitchell, but Mitchell's been able to have five so far, including three clearances. There's the tap across the 50. Josh Kennedy, again, as Cordes said, getting plenty of it. Moore with the steal and the release, and Malcheski's been shoved in the back. Now it's Jared Moore who's been shoved in the back.
Right on his distance here, I reckon Moore. I think he'll probably try and pass off.
Yeah, too far, I think. Let's see. Yeah, he does. He centres it, hoping that Hall can get there. He can't, but Guerra was there, high contact, coughed it up. Malcheski almost with the spirit of the Socceroos. Well done, Jolly. Muscled his way through. And by sheer will, McVeigh kicks the goal.
Just the effort here from Darren Jolly. I reckon he's got more of this in him, Darren Jolly. He's playing against a young ruckman, Renoff, only in his 10th game. tonight's the night, I reckon. Darren Jolly's really got to take the game by the scruff of the neck, push forward, try and get on the scoreboard.
Hit outs, Luke, 8-0 in favour of Sydney.
No and problem with that. He gets his hand on the footy walls, Darren Jolly. He's a fantastic player, great competitor. Last week just had 10 disposals. I reckon he's got another level in his game still, Woolsey. I reckon he's got the ability to take a risk more, push forward. He should dominate tonight. He's up against an experienced ruckman. Really should take him on tonight.
Mitchell. Unsuccessful attempt at a handball. Spills free. Crouch with his head over the ball. He's gang tackled by three Hawks.
No chance for tackle.
Leading stat getter so far, McVeigh 6.
Not that man, of course.
No, Mitchell 5 for the Hawks.
If it took Paul Roo's advice to come and watch Buddy, you'd be disappointed so far because he hasn't touched it. In fact, he's the only person on Hawthorn's team that hasn't touched it.
Renoff's given away another free kick. How many is that? I think that's 3 against Renoff.
And he gave away a few last week, didn't he? From memory.
And here's a loose man. Well, it's his opponent, Jolly, who's run free. Can he make Renoff pay?
No, well,
not quite, but well played by Jolly.
It's exactly what I've been talking about. He has got that in his game, that ability to push forward. There's his opponent, Renoff, who's had a few issues early, Woolsey.
Well, he has, Luke. He's their number 3 ruckman, Renoff, after Campbell and Taylor. Campbell's out injured, missed the first 2 games. Let's not be too critical of this fella here, Renoff. Simon Taylor's the one we should be critical of because he got himself reported last week. He put the knee into Joel Selwood's head, got the couple of weeks suspension. He let himself down, Taylor, and he's letting his team down. And you can see the third level ruckman is struggling. It'll be a good experience for him, but Taylor should be out there playing.
The issue is, I'm not sure who's going to help Renoff out tonight because there's no one else. I reckon he's got to do just about 80 to 90% of it himself tonight. And that, in the end, it might be a real factor for Sydney.
Renoff's given away 6 free kicks this season already, Rob.
Yeah. Well, look, young ruckman, inexperienced ruckman do that. He probably the best advice, Luke, would be in ruck contests, really work hard to be in front because if you get caught behind, arms over the shoulder, in the back, they tend to do it.
Well, there's a real jack-in-a-box there, Kieran. Jack coming off the bench. They didn't know he was coming off, and he almost stole the mark, but the Hawks are going to have the last laugh, or are they? This is Grundy under the pump here from Brown. Handball had to be good.
Oh,
he found a way through LRT.
That's the rugby skills, huh?
Yeah, sensational stuff. And Richards handling the loose ground pretty well also. McVeigh, that's just handball, handball, handball here for the Sydney. Bird looks it over the top. Not good delivery for Malcheski. Opens the door for Guerra. Taken out of it. Jack can't surely weave his way through there. He bit off way more than he could chew, and it was disappointing for Sydney because they had some numbers, and I guess who's done the tackling? We shouldn't be surprised. Rioli, just about the number one clamp man in the competition. Speaking of being clamped, Bateman knows what that's like now. What was that for?
Hands in the back. That was a two-handed shove, which we understand the players know that. It's the glancing one and the brush, the inconsequential one that I've got an issue with. That was a free kick.
It's interesting, we see Sam Mitchell, he's gone to the forward line, deep forward, and Brett Kirk's gone with him. So I think Alistair Clarkson would be happy to have Kirk out of the action.
So inside the Hawks attacking 50 again, Roughhead doing the ruck work, which we suspected might happen inside the attacking 50. He has a ping at the goals, and it's a rush behind.
So what happens then, Wolsey, when he goes... Does Renoff go off, or does he just sort of rest while he's out there?
We'll have to wait and see, but have a look at Roberts Thompson. You said that was wonderful play. I think that was duck your head and hope.
Well, it was wonderful play then.
Would you reckon, Rob, that probably Roughhead will do all the rucking inside the 50 arc, wouldn't
you? I think Roughhead will do the ruck work up forward, but you wouldn't want to put Roughhead in the ruck itself. You don't want him in at centre bounces. You don't put thoroughbreds in their quarters.
Speak of the devil, here is Roughhead. Spilt the beans, but still kicks the banana.
Here's a look at that last goal from the Hawks from Jared Roughhead.
Just the athleticism, Hutto, for a player that size and that size of frame, to fumble and be able to gather and kick it on the run like that is just elite.
Swans just nurdle the ball inside 50, not with any conviction, but McVeigh made a good decision to handball. He was under pressure. O'Keefe off the left, sums it up pretty well, but just can't get the angles right. And They've had a few near misses, Sydney, haven't they? So if they can get their act together, they're not out of this, but Hawthorn got so much firepower up forward. They lead by 16.
Jews kick in successful to Young, who goes long. Brown's caught behind. Good mark. Well played. Good stuff there from Heath Grundy. He gives it off to Craig Bolton.
Well, Craig Bolton doing a great job on Buddy.
Roberts Thompson over to Richards. He also goes long, but he blazed to what's all Hawthorn. And guess who? Just riding shotgun at halfback.
They would have spent a lot of time on the track this week planning to do exactly not that. Whatever you do, don't kick it high to halfback against Hawthorn. And Teddy Richards has just had a brain fade there.
Williams got to beat a couple. Flies high, brought the ball to ground. Grundy's there for Sydney. Clean hands over to Shaw. And that's a good possession from Shaw. And spots up a teammate at halfback.
Robert Thompson shaken up at halfback.
Goes all the way back to fullback to try and affect the switch for Bolton. He's got Mattner on over the top. If he moves it quickly, it got a little bit of touch on the way. Puts the pressure on Marty, who gets it away to Shaw. From halfback, oh, again, they're just playing into Hawthorn's arms and Birchall's in particular. And the goals will open up here for Mark Williams. Took a time to size it all up. And when he'd done that, he just went back and popped it through for his third.
Well, Luke Hodge, here's some examples of just being third man in defence. Just that spare unit. There he is again.
And they would have done a lot of planning for this quarter. They know that Hodge is going to play that sweeping role across half back, but they just cannot get through their half forward line, Sydney. They've played exactly in to Luke Hodge's hands. They've bombed the footy away, and Hodge has been able to just dominate, hasn't he?
Well, Hodge is the spare man in defence, and Mattner is the spare man in defence for Sydney at the moment. And I think when you're well down like this, you need to cover Hodge.
Another free kick against Renoff. Silly play.
Well, he'll just get caught behind all the time. Will be interesting, Luke, to see how Renoff gets a spell, because you'd imagine that he can't go all night, but he's rucked all this quarter.
He's going to need one at some stage. Only his 10th game of footy against one of the best big men in the competition in Jolly. He will blow up at some stage.
Beautifully roved by Moore. Now, here's an opportunity for O'Keefe. But again, a couple of Hawks pick him off. One of them was Hodge. And we'll have a throw in Sydney's forward pocket. Inside 50s this quarter, 15-8 in favour of the Hawks.
Let's look at Renoff here and just see how he positions himself with Jolly.
Jolly, good tap to Meredith. To Craig, to Jude Bolton, kicks to the hot spot. Oh, too strong for Murphy.
Well,
and it all started from Jolly again.
It did. And Jolly's too strong and too experienced for him.
I was watching Murphy through the glasses then, Robbie. Had a bit of a go at Hodge, which is brave. And Hodge put his hand up and acknowledged that he didn't quite get there to help.
Well, he can't miss this one, Barry. He doesn't. Second goal for Sydney.
And the boundary work of Darren Jolly, strength and talent to tap it to the advantage. Young Meredith dishes off the handball.
What about Hall? Just get him away, son.
Now, was that a bad enough bounce? The umpire doesn't recall it. He doesn't usually get too many wrong, Matthew James. His bouncing is normally beautiful. He does most distressed with that bounce.
He does that better than almost anyone else. So we're speaking a lot about this contest between Jolly and Renoff, but I reckon it's an opportunity for Sydney to really get back into the contest. Brett Kirk might have had a bit of a whack on the head. That'll happen about another 15 times tonight. But he's got to be tired, Renoff. He's only in his 10th game, and Darren Jolly has a real chance to really dominate here.
Neither Kirk nor Buddy Franklin have had a possession. You can see why Kirk hasn't. He's very defensive mind frame of mind.
Buddy's moving down to the contest, but we'll just keep an eye on Jolly. He just backs into Renoff. He'll just work to back into him and maybe get any advantage of a free kick.
He's knocked it into the space this time. Here's Ablett. And Mattner is clear for the moment. McVeigh had Jack running with him, delayed it. Here's Kirk's first touch. And it's nicely placed. If O'Keefe just can't get there. As we said, that's where the going's pretty tough out there. High one. Good! Oh, what a leap! Straight up into the night sky. And Adam Goods can have a shot for goal for the Swans.
Smart kick. Ryan O'Keefe, he played it really well. Didn't try and overdo it, put it to the spot. Percentage played. It was just set up for Adam Goods. He had a great ride. Fantastic call from Hutto. And we know he's capable of it. Sensational, Mark.
Well, they are back in it if he can kick straight, but it's quite a big if for the Swans at the moment. Looks good. So three goals for Sydney, 3-4, and Hawthorn 5-2, seven scoring shots each. Jolly's having a rest.
Jolly's having a rest, and it looks as though here's the replay of the Goods mark. It was an absolute beauty.
I think Thorpe into the ruck for
Mitch
the Hawks.
Thorpe is going to come in and take a centre square bounce, which I'm not sure he would have done too much in his career. He's probably played more as a key position player, so that'll be interesting. He needs to. Renoff can't keep doing the centre square bounce. He needs a spell. He looks very, very tired.
He does. He needs oxygen.
So despite Hawthorn's dominance, they're only 10 points in front. Spectacular mark from Adam Goods. White got that tap. There's Schoenmakers. Quick kick. Franklin yet to touch the football. Getting there first as Roughhead runs out of room.
Did he deliberately go over the line?
Absolutely. Yeah, had no other intention, but...
He should have been penalised for that.
Blame Luke.
So third man up was Ellis, of all people, in the ruck contest. Jude Bolton to Goods. Lovely delivery to Shaw, who's just run down by Stokes. Managed to get boot to ball. Good tackle on McVeigh. That was by Bateman. Now the Hawks work it inside 50. Good use of the body by Crouch. Bit of experience there against Brown. But the handball missed the target. Richards under the pump. Ball still in play. Roughhead. Good smother. Well played, Richards. And there's another go at it. He's hemmed in. Throws it on the boot, and it's a good kick too. Goods will fly again. And that's a good effort from young Schoenmakers to force the spoil there.
He's a bit of the wild card, isn't he, now, Goods? Das, I mean, he's taken the mark, his confidence up.
He's the one that you look to and say, if Sydney can pull off an upset win, and it will be an upset win, Adam Goods has to have one of those nights where he just kicks three or four and has about 25 possessions. He started really well.
Kennedy got the hurry kick. That was Williams surrounded. Swans just starting to get a lot more hands on the ball, aren't they? You can see them teaming. It's their disposals out of defence that's letting them down. Again, the turnover. Birchall for Brown. Here's Buddy for the first time. He was going everywhere, but the ball, but Morton's able to slam it on the boot. It bounces astray.
That's an interesting matchup, isn't it? Bateman's gone onto Goods. Now, if they can get some high ball into the forward line, you'd think that Chance Bateman would struggle. Chance Bateman's a wonderful player, but he's on a man a lot bigger than him. And I reckon he's pointing to the bench, Bateman, saying, get me out of this hole.
Matner to kick it in. It's the Hawks by 11 as we near... Oh, he's mucked that up. Matner, can he get out of danger? He does it well in the end. He gets it to Crouch, who kicks to Bolton. He takes the mark at half back. Plays on. There's Hall. Couldn't mark it. Wasn't the best of kicks. Gee, attacking it was Birchall. That was well done. And he's rewarded with a free kick. Well done, Grant Birchall.
That's where Hawthorn is so good at turning the footy over, in that middle part of the ground towards half-back. You need to be able to pierce through. Then Adam Goods was actually out the back on his own. Turnover occurred, and Hawthorn often go now and hurt you on the rebound.
Brown to Ellis. Kicks into the pocket. Franklin's got to beat a couple. He flies high. Couldn't take it on the second bite. He might have got a free here in the back.
Yes.
So Buddy's first touch for the match.
You said it in the call though, Quarters. He's got to beat a couple. And Sydney have been dropping one back in front of him all of this first quarter.
Franklin hooks it around and he sneaked it home for 1 point.
Could the extra attention on Franklin during the week have had any impact on his preparation, or does he enjoy that?
Doesn't strike me as a sort of bloke that would be in one iota phased about extra attention.
No, but he had to do the media and had to be the idiot, focused and all that sort of stuff.
Have a look at him. Does he
no.
Look like he'd be too concerned about that.
How's he
Excellent
going?
Effort from Sydney. Only 5 seconds to go in this quarter. Hawthorn have dominated, and they always stay in the game, Sydney. Only 2 goals down.
End of the quarter, and they are within reach, but... Good lead for Hawthorn of 2 goals, Rob.
Yes, and the Hawks shot out of the gate, didn't they? And Mark Williams in his 100th game, so effective up forward. Buddy, he's struggling to get into the game, got his first kick only a minute ago. But it was good to see Barry Hall mark and goal. Adam Gooch took a specky, he marked and goal. Got the Sydney supporters up on their feet. So, as you mentioned, it looked like Hawthorn, but Sydney not too far behind.
For sure.
Fantastic. Enjoy the rest of the night. Keep cheering for the Swans. There we go. Quarters, Jess Mowboy, 2006 Australian Idol runner-up.
Thank you, Corey. As we start the third term, it's the Swans into attack. Oh, Guerra missed Malcheski, and now he puts Sydney inside 50. Murphy against Hall in the pocket. Murphy plays the safe option.
Oh,
it's a bad handball from Whitecross, I think it was. And Meredith in his first game has just missed.
And that is very loose play by the youngster.
And Whitecross has it, I should say Meredith as a junior, was known to be able to snag a goal or two from the Northern Knights, so he'll be disappointed he missed that opportunity. Margin is 11 and the Hawks looking dangerous here. Rioli had a long time to work out where to go to and he chose Campbell Brown. Good decision. Is it 50? No, it's not.
Oh, I just really overplayed that, Marty Matner, on the boundary line. He had to know that you couldn't allow Cyril Rioli out the back, and it was just a mistake. He went to make the contest, but as soon as he went over it, it just opened up the whole forward 50, and Rioli's such a clever player. He was always going to make them pay.
What a turnaround, and what it could have been if Meredith had been able to put the goal through. Now Brown to stretch it out to 17 points. And he made the goal up by work just a fraction, but it's through safely.
Interesting setup, Rob. Brown in the goal square and sort of flanking him, a rough head and Franklin.
Yeah, I like it. But I also like Renoff there, quarters. He was the one who set it up. He took the mark, and it was a really nice pass by the ruckman to the half forward line. And they are mixing their forward setups up, their forward structures, and I like that. I think that's really good. You're just always guessing as the opposition. Will Buddy line up inside the 50 by himself? Will he be at full forward? Will he come up onto the wing? And they just never settle down. Last week, of course, we saw the two Hawthorn stars have the 50 to themselves in that last quarter against Geelong, and they did it so well.
Mitchell with the football. Little chip out wide to Bateman. It's not the best, a shocking kick in fact by Bateman for Franklin. Oh, intercepted here by Schoenmakers. Out to Rioli, tough angle, keeps it alive. Brown's got to beat some tall timber, manages to bring the ball to ground, but in doing so gave away the free kick. And the free kick's going to Heath Grundy.
Good shot of how quickly Hawthorn set up. Look at all their players, they're guarding space, not going to a man. It just puts that doubt in Jared McVay's mind now. Do I try and pierce a kick through it, or I have to go the safety down the line? He's got to go the safety because they manned that up really well.
Too strong for Ablett. And he goes inboard looking for Schoenmakers. He got the free kick against Bevan for a one over the shoulder. Another left footer recruited by the Hawks.
Beautiful,
and that
kick
is a magnificent kick to Franklin, who dropped it. Having an off night, Buddy. Here's Hodge. Oh, good kick. Oh, no, Franklin dropped it. Roughhead dropped it as well. The Twin Towers both spilt the ball. And Hawthorn finished with a point, but a drop mark from Franklin. One from Roughhead.
Yes, and there's the first one. And Buddy's not having a great night. Mind you, he's on a really good player in Craig Bolton, but he should have held that, and Roughhead should have held that. They'd be disappointed with their efforts there.
And Kennedy finished with the point.
So 6-5. To 3-5 here. And the Swans have had a pretty tough time getting the ball cleanly out of defence. And again, they've got to work really hard. They had the numbers there, but Stuart Jew's able to escape. He's just given up the free. It's going to be Richard's ball, I think, maybe against Xavier Ellis.
I reckon Stuart Jew might have hurt himself. He's heading towards the interchange. He might have just nicked a hammy.
Malcheski lets fly. Whitecross out of position. He got back nicely, though, to affect the spoil. Swans with numbers here. Jolly standing start. He sees goods. He just saw him out of the corner of his eye. Well done, two important playmakers for Sydney there, and Jolly and Goods.
Started really well. Adam Goods started this quarter at half forward, but we know he's got the license to play the old James Heard role. wherever he wants to take himself. And I love the fact that he's pushing forward. If he gets a mismatch, he wants to back himself in. Work really hard to get this one, Wolsey.
It's interesting, isn't it? We've seen Hodge fumble at ground level and Franklin and Roughhead drop what for them are easy marks.
Duke coming off, but it's moving okay. That's a beautiful kick from Adam Goods.
Yeah, Dewey on the bench, boys. He made a beeline there after this incident, Wolsey, talked about. The runner pulled him off. He did seem to be moving quite well, so we'll keep an eye on him, but he seems to be okay.
Adam Goods. I like Adam Goods in the forward line because we've seen him on Bateman, and now he's on Guerra, men who are much shorter than him, and we've seen Goods mark and goal late in the first quarter, early in the second.
Renoff did well to Guerra. Too high, though, for Roughhead to catch.
He's such a good tackler, Cyril Rioli. It was the way he just executes it is so well for a lightly framed player. He makes it hurt and he makes him pay. Really gets involved.
Roughhead to do the ruck work jolly, though, comfortably. To Roberts Thompson. Now Moore. And his kick finds Bird. As the Swans work it around the outer flank, looking for Bevan. Ah, good mark in front of Guerra. Bevan's got it for the Swans, who are only two goals down. He'll go back deep inside defensive 50 to Bolton. He'll switch to Roberts Thompson, to Richards. Now Jude Bolton, a long ball of Hall, works his way to the front. Third man up on that occasion was Renoff, as we go back down to Corey Wingard.
Yeah, we mentioned Dewey looked okay. Then Chance Bateman came off just a few moments after. Looked like he'd rolled an ankle. He's just trying to jog it off around the boundary now, but not feeling all that comfortable, Chance Bateman.
You say that again, look at him labouring along the boundary there.
Dangerous situation for Hawthorn. Jolly. That was a shocking boundary throw-in.
That's one of your pet hates, Rob.
They practice all week and then you get a bad throw-in.
Rioli turned Matter inside out there with some very good skill. Now he weighs up the options. He pumps it long. Franklin again has got to beat two. Franklin flies! Hasn't got it! Franklin has been play on as the call. He kicks a goal anyway! Well, he thought he got the mark, but the umpire didn't pay it. The thing about it, Rob, he stood up in the tackle and he managed to get boot to ball.
He did, and he's a freak, isn't he? Let's have a look at it. As you call, two against one. He leapt that little bit early. Certainly got first bite at it. He thought he might have marked it and didn't matter. And that might be just what he needs to get himself going.
Well, Franklin is now gold in the last 60 games he's played in, Rob. Who holds the record for that stat?
Peter Hudson.
No.
Jason Dunstall.
No. Close. He's a full forward and he did play up here a bit.
Lockett.
Correct. 114 games in a row he kicked a goal. Margin, Franklin up to 60.
Margin back to 18. What about Cyril Rioli again there? He didn't panic, did he? He let things just hold up until he got Franklin in a goal scoring position.
Did you see the change of pace though? When he looked around, he thought someone was going to catch him. I think it was Mattner, and he just had an extra gear that not many people have. He's such a good player.
Clinton Young being moved on to Adam Goods. Back of picture.
Bounce, but too long. Too long. It's too many degrees, apparently. Is that in the rules, Luke? 360 degrees.
I think it's the right decision.
McVeigh and Hall just going under the outstretched fingers of Hodge. He gets a little bit of pain on his shoulder.
Every time they get a one-on-one opportunity, you actually feel as though Hall, O'Keefe, and the forwards from Sydney look really dangerous. We know that Hawthorn have just set up so well, and there was Hodge in the pitch. He nearly got there. If they can get enough chances with these guys, they'll score.
He's on the runway then, Barry Hall. It's a big kick, isn't it? Three goals down. That's with great authority from Barry Hall. So the Swans are not going to die easily.
And Corey, I think there's another injury to the Hawks, Campbell Brown.
Yeah, just walking the boundary there, Rob, and he does look a little bit ginger. We know the boys last game against Geelong, of course, three-quarter time, a lot of them cramping up. So soft tissues are a concern for the Hawks here tonight.
Mitchell's kick's smothered, ricochets to Jolly. He just throws it on the boot without much success. There's Hodge. Got it to Birchall. Now White cross. Finds Moss. Long ball to Rioli. Oh, push out. Yep. Oh, it's a free kick going to Williams.
Yeah, I thought it could have been against Rioli.
I thought it was for a push against Rioli. So Williams has got it at half forward. Franklin, there's three players hovering around him. They still kick it to him. Couldn't get it. That spills to Goods. Little check side, inside out. Kick was absolutely brilliant to Richards. Can he get a kind bounce? No, he can't.
He knew he was out there, didn't he? At the corner of his eye, Adam Goods saw his teammate. And we see Stuart Dew coming back on field.
So he's okay. Margin is 12. Here's Jolly and Renoff. Ellis is every time trying to get up.
That's interesting. That's interesting. Third man up. I think Alistair Clarkson's decided that Renoff will struggle in the ruck contest. So we may well see third man up. Ellis coming over the top there.
You hope the Sydney midfielders react really quickly to that. If you've got a dominating ruckman, don't allow your opponent to go third man up. Give Jolly, there it is again.
There it is again, yeah, absolutely. That's a play that they've decided on after Renoff got beaten comprehensively in that first quarter.
Kirk's now had three kicks and, or three possessions and three tackles because he's playing such a defensive role on Sam Mitchell. Adam Goods got clear for a moment there, but not the execution he would have liked.
Bit of umpire contact there, backing out. Mitchell and Brett Kirk involved. I don't think too much to worry about that.
There it is. Ellis got blocked there. He was setting himself to leap over the top.
Kirk got the handball out. Desperation from Moss. The onus is on him to move it on. He did. Bolton likewise. Schoenmaker's been pretty good tonight. There's Moss again. They're just thrusting their bodies around in there. You'd expect it to be tough and tight when the Swans are playing.
Now, still reckon Darren Jolly. There's Barry Hall one-on-one in the goal square. And Alistair Clarkson getting animated in the box. I reckon Darren Jolly can go for a bit more here. Try a hit. Try and actually get one into the middle of the ground and really try and score from these clearances.
Richards heard the call of the umpire. His fist to a nest of Hawks. This is Ellis. He's a normally an exquisite kick. And now it's one-on-one Crouch and Rioli. And they all overran it. Moss, pretty ingenious there with the handball and the damaging and dangerous Cyril. No one can lay a hand on him in the area of Franklin. Jolly did enough. Crouch could tell that Buddy was nearby. Just slammed it on the boot. Here's Schoenmakers. And there's Bolton, and he knows all about
it. Tackle.
Play on was the call. Moss with a little drop kick. Ellis playing for a free. Won't get any favours from the umpire. Threw it. Play on again. Bolton. Got some high contact. Some exasperated boys. The other factor is, Bonnet Thompson said today after the Geelong game that they pulled up sore after a bruising encounter last Friday night with the Hawks. So as the game goes on, it'll be interesting to see what the fitness is like and the freshness of the Hawks. It's Craig Bird getting the attention this time.
Bit of blood on the snoz. So Jude Bolton at half back. Rough head. Couldn't take the mark. Back of the pack is Murphy. Hovering his goods. Weight of numbers one out there for the Hawks. Young. Not a great handball to Schoenmakers. Puts him right under the hammer. And consequently coughs it up. Here's Hall with strength. Busts a couple of tackles. And finds his co-captain in Kirk.
Well done before from Craig Bird. In the hands of the trainers, came out and laid a really important tackle.
Goods kept on running. Good spoil by Whitecross.
It's a good effort.
I'll correct myself there. Hall's no longer a co-captain.
There he is on screen. Bird was dazed and a little bit out of it. And he looked up and thought, I've got to go here, and laid an important tackle.
Birchall fed it out to Mitchell, to Moss. Gee, it's tough in the clinches at the moment. Ellis to Roughhead on his wrong side. So turns back on the left.
Roughhead can help down back. We've seen that in the past.
Gee, they've got a man on now on the wing, the Hawks. They're about to break through. Breakthrough's Josh Kennedy. Some issues. Gets Mitchell. Just pops up nicely. Jack pursuing desperately. Franklin again, two to beat. Looking for some help from the umpire. Roberts Thompson drifting over the top of Bolton. Shaw springs into action for Grundy. The margin is still 12. We're at the halfway stage of this second quarter. Next goal is always important, but it feels like it's absolutely vital here as far as the Swans are concerned. Grundy takes his time and delivers for Bird. Oh, he fumbled. He's either hurt himself again.
He's hurt his left knee, had he?
Yes, he's gone down. There's a shove from Roberts Thompson. So Bird limps off. the ball is out of bounds.
Buddy doing the ruck work.
Won easily by White, who tapped it to Craig Bolton. Schoenmakers in front. Now Moore comes up with a football for Sydney. He's got to loose man on the wing, O'Keefe. We're going to have a bit of a run. Now goes Hall. Beautiful delivery. Hall with strength.
Fantastic kick. It really was well weighted.
Hall plays on. Oh, Bazza! What were you thinking? Oh, he was only 15 metres out and the angle wasn't bad. Hang your head, Bazza.
Just, it's too unselfish. I mean, you're a gun full forward. You've kicked over 500 goals in your career. You just got to go back and kick that barrier. And I think he knew it as soon as he pulled the trigger.
Kick not perfect out of defence. Moss shown already that he'll be committed at the footy. Gets was delisted and came back as a rookie, so he'll be hungry. There's Barry so often. It was really a poor execution, wasn't it?
Jared Ruffhead doing the ruck work.
Against Jesse White. Bolton underneath, but Mitchell. Oh, just he's dangerous kicking. Nothing was going to get in his road there.
Hawks won't be all that happy having Franklin and Ruffhead do ruck work. They're forced into it because Renoff is the only ruckman that they've got.
Down to you, Corey.
Boys getting very busy down here on the boundary line. Chance Bateman has had his ankle strapped. He's pushing to come back on. Bird getting his knee looked at, just making sure there's no looseness in that. And Renoff, your man Rob Walls, getting a big rub on his legs.
They're going for Hall again. There was some jumper there. And the umpire... That's Michael Vozzo's explanation. Do you agree with him?
Again, we'll have a look at the ruck work. Ruffhead doing it. Not ideal for Hawthorn. Another shocking throw-in.
Well, the Hawks enjoyed it. McVay, that's got to be close to holding the ball. Play on the call. And three Hawthorn players applying the tackle there on Luke Ablett.
I don't know who's copying it more, the boundary umpire or Simon Taylor tonight.
Well, Simon Taylor, he should be embarrassed by being suspended last week for what he did, because he's making it very hard for his teammates.
Sure. Here's Franklin. He's gang-tackled by three.
Oh, look at that.
They're double and triple teaming, buddy, tonight, and so far it's worked a treat.
Just an update. Let's have a look at the contest there on the wing. One of the contests that I've been looking forward to watching all week has been Sam Mitchell and Brett Kirk. An update on that. Mitchell's had 9 disposals and Kirk's had 6. So Brett Kirk's reeled him back in pretty well.
With Vader Moore. He floats one back inside 50. Is that a mark? Yeah, umpire's paid it. And it's taken by Malcheski.
I reckon they'd be feeling pretty good, Sydney, because...
It's only 11 points, Rob.
I think, Barry's starting to look dangerous up forward. Adam Goods is playing well. Sam Mitchell's being controlled. Franklin has had no influence on the game. They'd have to be starting to think, hey, we're a real chance.
Nick Malcheski. He started at left. It's coming back. It is right through the middle. It's a 5-point ball game.
Sam Mitchell pushed deep forward. Contested possessions for the match. And you can just see Sydney well and truly in it. Jolly and Hall coming good.
White went a little early, so Ruffhead is in the ruck. That was Bolton. Good, so it made it tough for Crouch. He adjusted nicely. White, and now Roberts Thompson streaming. Suddenly, Swans enjoying a little bit of freedom and latitude that won't last for long. Jack, let's fly. Has he got the target? He hasn't. It's such a crucial part in footy these days, isn't it? The kick into the 50. And Bateman's back out there, so he's had the running repairs. And he's up and going to another man who looked like he might have been down and out in Campbell Brown. And it's their specialty, Hawthorn. Good, clean ball use. Thorpe with his first touch of the night for Stokes. It's coming back, but just not quite enough. Shaving the post. And the lead now, one even goal, 7-6 to 6-6.
The kick in is marked by Craig Bolton. So the Swans work it out of defence. Crouch to Roberts Thompson, and his kick finds the first gamer in Meredith.
This is the crucial kick now. Trying to get through his half forward region's been an issue for him all night. Great kick.
Yep, good kick to Jack. He wheels around and pops it up. Good effort by Hodge, but he's outnumbered here. Ablett.
Jolly's dangerous.
Back to McVeigh. Hall wanted it. He didn't get it. And Jolly in the pocket has taken the mark.
Well, I reckon Jared McVeigh has got a few teammates looking at him saying, OK, came off, but maybe you should have centred that one. He had the banana shot at goal, and fortuitously Jolly was able to mark it, but he probably didn't do the right thing there, Jared McVeigh, by his teammates.
You're spot on, Luke. You're spot on. Jolly was dangerous there for about 15 seconds, and the Sydney players knew it, except for McVeigh. Maybe he did know it, but thought, I'll go for the miracle goal.
Well, there's a nice kick for goal, Darren Jolly. This to level the scores.
And let's have a look at Buddy Franklin and Roughhead doing ruck work, which they're not used to, and they'll get beaten up against Jolly and White. And this is a real concern. Again, a hit out to Sydney's advantage.
Back where we started, but the Swans with momentum. Jack's kicking to the 50, covered off nicely by Hodge. And 50.
It's going to go against Barry Hall, this, off the footy, trying to stop Thomas Murphy from running down the ground, and just grabbed hold of his jumper. Umpire was right there, and that's the rule. You can't hold on to a player and stop him from running on down the ground. So free kick was spot on.
Hodge then, and they didn't get enough numbers back in front of Franklin. So, is this beyond him? Swans need to get some tall timber back, and Darren Jolly's well aware. They've got the big zone back, Sydney, so there's no passes on. So the question now is, can Franklin put Hawthorn back in front? And 55 metres out. Not going to be a goal, but they are back in front. Jared McVeigh's had 19 disposals, boys, which is huge in one half of footy.
Yeah, he's turning himself into an elite midfielder, Jared McVeigh. Been able to kick goals. He kicked a bag of six last year from the midfield and forward against the Bulldogs. So really important player for Sydney now.
Matt Nittishaw, who returns the favour. That was awkward, to say the least.
Had some real issues in their kick out, Sydney. It's been turned over a huge amount. They haven't been able to get through Hawthorn's zone setup, and it's causing them some trouble.
Williams to Brown, one out with Crouch. Stokes does the roving. Great tackle.
And the Hawthorn supporters say deliberate rush behind, but they're not going to get it.
Reece Shaw brings him in quickly to Roberts Thompson. Not a lot on next for him here, though.
Four minutes to go, Hutto, and Hodge has gone to the bench. Sydney, if they can get it up into their forward line without Hodge, they're a real chance.
Just an example of where Hawthorn, there's Luke Hodge, copped a bit of a whack over the head. He'll be fine. He's as tough as anyone in the game. But Hawthorn do this, and here's their zone, better than anyone in the competition. It's so hard to get through. Sydney are having all sorts of trouble.
Jolly almost was able to drag it down. That's Morton. Not sure where to head, so he just goes backwards to find some space. Birchall popped up just at the right time for him. Stretching the handball with a bit of a run-up. Young, oh, they're going up behind the goals. It drifts, though, and the margin is three.
Real credit to Alistair Clarkson and his coaching staff. We know that Sydney are playing really well. They're back to within 3 points, but there's a lot of new players on the ground. It's as young a team as they've fielded for years, and yet everyone knows their role. They're doing it really well. They're manning up the space exactly the way the coach wants them to. Here's a really good shot of it. Guarding space. That's the 18-man press. Hawthorn, they've engineered it better than anyone.
Mark taken by Grundy. It's the Hawks by 3 points. Matner, little one to Crouch. He's in the twilight of his career. Had that incredible streak from his debut when he played 194 games in a row.
You have to kick it really well to get through. Your foot disposal's got to be good or it'll come straight back.
Crouch found a teammate there in McVeigh. He's having his 20th possession in the match. Best and fairest winner of last season. Swan's just tossing it around at the moment, trying to find a hole.
It's not like they're deliberately, though, tossing it around and trying to hold up play. They just can't get out, can they?
takes some courage, Hutto. It takes someone to actually go up the middle of the ground, pinpoint a 30 or 40 metre pass, or do this, handball and run on and try and get around it that way.
Well, Malcheski did run hard, and he might be rewarded here. Well, his team might be rewarded. Jolly at half forward. Tries to get rid of it unsuccessfully. Williams back in the back half at the moment. He finds Birchall. Is that 15? Either way, it wasn't the best of kicks. Morton fell over the ball.
He's
going to be penalised for sure. Got to be penalised. No, it came out. Young's there. He's tackled by Goods. Now Jude Bolton to Malcheski. Hurriedly on the boot. An opportunity for Hall. Works his way to the front. Kept it in possession to Kirk. It was a strange old kick from Brett Kirk on his wrong side.
You very rarely see Brett Kirk kick on his right foot.
That's why.
And we know why.
The tragedy was Jared McVeigh was out. Wolsey was 15 metres. There he goes passing the screen. So he's just got to pop it over. Look at McVeigh saying, you can't do that, surely.
Again, we'll have a look at the ruck contest. This is where the Hawks are really struggling.
Jolly knows it. Ran off from behind. Goods in front was the target. Williams able to sneak in there.
Right tackle.
Yeah, Kirk again. Lassoing him in. There's Goods around the body for McVeigh. Jew steadfast because the mark paid. Has been. McVeigh attempted the impossible before.
I reckon he'll centre this one. I think, well, maybe not. I reckon he might have got a message from his teammates last time. Don't try the impossible. But
I think he fancies himself, Luke.
He's going the other way.
74 goals, 50 over his career. Jared McVeigh. We mentioned that the pockets aren't, shouldn't be that deep, as the boundary line's in a fair way than what it normally is. But I think he should have centered it. So back to 2 points.
Sugar fix for Paul Ruse. As Guerra brings it in. Corey Wingard.
Luke Hodges come back on, boys. Got up off the bench, just rubbed the back of his head and walked back out there, just the way Luke Hodges likes to play.
Franklin to Morton, looking for support. None forthcoming. Oh, manages in the end to get it back to Franklin.
It'll be against, I think it'll be 50 against Barry Hall, because he put Morton down after he handballed it. It's the new rule.
I thought it was in the act of handballing, though.
Yeah, well, I'd like to see it again.
It's a big 50.
It's a pretty tough call, but that's the new rule. Now let's have a look at it.
Oh, jeez. There was one today I saw in one of the matches.
Yeah, it was an absolute shocker today.
Yeah, Skills Stadium, wasn't it?
But the umpires, like the players, make mistakes. That's a mistake.
That wasn't in the DVD, that one.
No, he got that wrong, and they make blues, and unfortunately this is going to cost Sydney really badly.
Right through the middle for Morton.
Here's another look
here
at it.
Here it is, Hutto. And look, that's the issue with it. I think players are smart. They kind of go to ground and try and build the free kick, and that's what he did. Nothing in that. He didn't retard him, didn't slam to the ground.
No.
And umpires, he's just got it wrong.
He's a big, strong man tackling a skinny boy, and he is a young player, and he just about done his run anyway. He got rid of the ball, he'd run with it, he got touched, and he went to ground. Common sense, please.
Look at those disposals. There is quite a disparity between the two sides overall. It's 196 to 143, mainly due to the extra handballs. They've had 40 more handballs than Hawthorn, the Sydney Swans. But they're 8 points behind. Wouldn't they love to snatch one before halftime? Moore had Goods away, just couldn't release it. And 14 seconds is not going to be a lot of time for either side to score a goal. Barry's got half time to try and cool down. He's had 4 marks, 7 disposals, and 2 goals, 2. Still shapes as pretty influential in this game. Kirk with the high ball. They might get the chance yet. Jesse White.
And again, it was Darren Jolly getting first use of the footy, playing the percentages. Really well done. Opportunity for Sydney to exploit that in the second half. They've got a domination in the ruck.
He's never kicked a goal. In fact, he's never scored before, I don't think. He was famous last year for being the 19th man in that match against North Melbourne. Big moment for young Jesse White. He's got the distance and he's got the accuracy. So what a way to go into halftime. The Swans trailing by just 2 points. And we've got a great second half coming your way. All right, we're underway in the second half, and the Swans just 2 points away from the lead. I guess the thing in Hawthorn's favour is they haven't got a lot yet out of their two big guns up forward, have they? Franklin and Rufford. You have to think they'd get more product out of them in the second half.
Against that, Hutto, Ryan O'Keefe, just the 3 touches for Sydney in the first half. You'd expect him to play a lot better.
Certainly would. He's had Whitecross down there for company. He might get involved in the play here because Sydney are going to get the first meaningful clearance of the second half.
And Sydney starting with Adam Goods in that forward 50, playing on Guerra.
So they're loading up forward, Sydney. Jack tries to hit Goods. He should get him here. Will he give? Doesn't the hand pass. Richards kept on running. Goods for Bolton. Oh, it made it tough for Richards. Tried to keep the hands clear, but he couldn't. Surely that's holding the ball. Mark? Let's have a look. Did he have a chance? His hands were clear. Didn't really make a big effort. Anyway, the ball's out of bounds, and now it's hurling back. Jolly. McVeigh. Here's Goods again. He really does loom. He just dropped it at the key moment, and Alice Shaw disorientated. Stokes circling. He had some support. There's O'Keefe. He's a bit out of sorts. Whitecross wins the day again. And now Stokes and Guerra. And the Hawks clean enough. And they're away. This is Kennedy.
Off to Franklin, who tries to split the pack, and he does, buddy, and he's off to the races. Little chip kick. Spectacular stuff from Franklin. Explosive. And Roughhead has got the footy within range.
And look at Buddy, he just keeps going. That super effort would have burned up so much energy, and yet it doesn't take anything out of him. Just backs himself there, the big fella. And this is a lovely, delicate little chip kick.
Jared Roughhead has kicked a goal in the first quarter. Just from one step, splits the middle. Hawks by 8.
Boys, concerns for Luke Hodge on the boundary line. He didn't take part of the warm-up after half-time. He was sitting in the dugout as his players did the warm-up. He's had a little jog around the boundary line. Of course, he copped that heavy knock in that second term, as you pointed out. He's rubbed the face a few times, but not sure he'll come back on. We'll keep an eye on him.
We're going to have a throw-up by the field umpire because the bounce disadvantaged one of the ruckmen, so he'll throw it up this time, not bounce it. And this is common sense. This is good.
Jacob Mollison, the umpire, throws it up. Jolly, even more certain that he was going to be able to get the tap down for Bolton. That's a desperate lunge, and it's paid for Ablett. McVeigh breaks away to his left. Does he honour the lead? McVeigh still screaming for it. Goods has gone the other way.
Barry's out there on the lead.
Hall makes his lead. He's going to go to Goods. It's going to get there before the ruckman can get back to help. Can he get over Birchall? No, he can't. He didn't have to, because O'Keefe has popped up in front of them all.
And O'Keefe, who we mentioned, has been out of the game. But this goal to Sydney all results from the ruck work of Jolly. And if Sydney win the game, they can thank Darren Jolly.
Well, long way to go yet, but O'Keefe splits the middle. It's back to 2 points.
And we'll just go back to that last goal that Sydney got. Jolly, hand on the ball. Down the throat to Jude Bolton. And forward it goes for a Sydney goal.
So all sorts of problems for the Hawks. Hodge is off also with what could be concussion. Speaking of that, Ellis caught one high. As the Swans are away again. Brown was brave. Here's an opportunity for more. To O'Keefe, another one. Oh, what a smother. Campbell Brown, a beauty. That saved a certain goal. He, not only did he go back with a flight of the ball, but then a smother, Rob. What about that?
Yes, and they're the things that we love. And no kick mark, handball, just a courageous and desperate and skillful smother. And what players do when they haven't got the ball is so important.
Jolly through the back door looking for McVeigh, not quite. And we'll have a bounce.
Why his teammates love him so much, Campbell Brown. He's just so desperate, so brave.
Opportunity here for the Swans. Jolly might do it himself. No, he had a fresh air. Goods. Still got it. Oh, got to be holding the ball. No, said the umpire. Malcheski's in there, and we'll have another bounce. goal here would put the Swans in front for the first time tonight.
They've been level, but they haven't been in front. Goods is waiting. Birchall's watching him, but it's Hall who gets the chance. He just took too long to get rid of it and allowed Ellis. He's just not quite there, is he, Barry Hall?
No, he's not.
Superb ruck work again, yeah. Though, Rob, wasn't it, too? It couldn't have done it any better. Set it up really well. They just needed a block. That's something the Sydney players, if they had been able to get him clear, it was a certain goal.
Franklin was the target. Why wouldn't he be? But G. Bolton's certainly done a wonderful job tonight.
Well, Craig Bolton's a wonderful player, Hutto. He All-Australian a couple of years back and started his career with Brisbane.
This is Kennedy having to go back, and again, it was ordinary handball. Guerra, I'm not sure what he was thinking there, but he's done it magnificently. He's pretty happy with it, I reckon, even though it was an absolute mongrel. It went the opposite way he wanted it to, but it stayed inside the field of play. And allows the Hawks to set up. But here is Jolly. Can his dominance continue? No free kick. Renouf over the top. Bateman. Okay, he did. Ellis did also a couple, in fact, a half forward. Morton comes out to meet it and does what he had to do around the corner, unfortunately. The anticipation was good from Richards, and he can send the Swans away. Bit of a fumble initially out there from young Meredith. Oh, kick was all right, but Moore's dropped an absolute plum pud, and he might really pay if the Hawks can get it down there. Franklin's one-on-one. Guerra goes longer. No, he doesn't. He goes to Franklin. Rioli's going to be hard to stop from there, and the umpire saw the little grab.
The penetrating kick of Guerra just put the Sydney defence under so much pressure. Hard, low drop punt.
That's about drop mark, though, Wolsey,
yeah,
doesn't it?
The fumbles kill you, turnovers. And just a little bit of a grab there. Crouch knew that he didn't have the pace to go with Rioli.
Make sure the umpire knew all about it, Sir Rioli. It was clever, wasn't a heap in it.
And he pops it through, so they've been able to hold Sydney at bay.
It's the Hawks by eight.
And Adam Good starting outside the square for this third quarter. Birchall his opponent. We've gone 8-9 minutes.
Knock it out! That's fine. He's trying to get rid of it. He's going down.
See Buddy Franklin there on screen just going to the defensive side of the contest. I think that's an instruction to him as well. Get up the ground. Craig Bolton's doing a really good job one-on-one. See if you can get involved in the play more across the middle of the ground.
Another stalemate. Take three in the middle.
You saw the hit-out stats before, obviously dominated by Jolly. The clearances are 27-19, Sydney's way.
This is interesting, Buddy. Yep. Third man up.
But it's all Sydney.
Hit it straight to his opponent.
Yep, and Good squeezes the kick out and finds Grundy. He's had a pretty good night. Richards. Free kick to Ablett. And he copped a nice hip and shoulder from Brown. And he gets up very gingerly. Meredith, as the advantage was paid, spotted up Malcheski, who's within range.
I like Brett Meredith's disposal. His foot disposal tonight for a first gamer. Little number seven has been first rate.
He's got good composure too, hasn't he, Wolsey? He seems to be able to hold his head well, make good choices.
Nick Malcheski kicked a goal in the second term. Nine disposals for the night. Looks good off the boot. It's back to 2 points the difference.
Here's Luke Hodge, and this is earlier on. We think we may have found what happened to Luke Hodge. Jared Ruffhead over the top and really causing him some pain there.
And Buddy coming in off the wing at this centre bounce.
Hawks only leading by two. Bit of hanging on, no advantage paid. Coming back to Adam Goods.
Goodsy just asking whether or not the 50-metre might apply. No joy there with the umpire. Renouf comes off. And it's going to be Mitch Thorpe into the ruck.
Yeah, Jolly's already off. That's not a great kick. Malcheski, though, was able to reel it in. And then searing ball onto Bird's chest. And I'm not sure everyone was convinced as to whether or not that mark was taken. Thomas Murphy certainly wasn't. But Bird's been paid it. He's going to have the shot.
I think Malcheski's enjoying playing in the forward line. Kicked two terrific goals. Knows what he's about when he's having a shot. Lovely pass to set up.
So Bird, he looked down and out earlier in the night. But he's recovered well, and Sydney are in front for the first time.
And that's a cue, boys, for Luke Hodge to come back out on the ground. I've watched him do three about 15-metre runs, and after each one, he's sat down. He's rubbed his head constantly. He's not in a good way, but that's the sort of leader he is. He won't leave his side down.
And he's gone onto the ground, and he's gone to the full forward position.
So the old heads of Sydney have thrown down the challenge to the young Hawthorn side. It's the Swans in front for the first time in the match. They might go further in it here. Malcheski for his third. It's a floater. And Murphy claims the mark, or is it a point? It's a point. Swans by four.
Quickly into Birchall. And then along the line for Franklin. Good bodywork from Bolton. Matner was good. Bolton got tripped over by his own man. Now he's got an issue. He's going to get out of this. He was dead set lucky there, Bolton. But he takes the free. Hall's deep in the goal square. Richards is also in the forward 50. O'Keefe, I should say, is down there. Moore has to kick under pressure. It's set up for Hall. He's got clear of Murphy, who's being held. Free or a mark. And it was the free, not the mark, because he actually dropped it.
Really clever kick from Jared Moore. He thought it through. Thought he was going to be able to accept the mark and go back. But when he played on, he summed it up really well. It was weighted to the perfect side of Hall. And one-on-one with Murphy,
yep.
Barry Hall, it's too strong and too good.
And I think, Luke, that the Sydney players are aware of that. Paul Roos would have instructed them to put it to Barry's advantage side. There's no Trent Crowe, there's no Gillam. So the two key defenders for Hawthorn, they're not there. Barry Hall should shine.
And shine he does. They're leading by 11.
Another thing, Rob, I've noticed, the shutdown job on Mitchell, who had five disposals and three clearances in the first quarter. Since then, the shutdown job's been terrific.
Yes, and Captain Kirk, you've got to give him full credit for that. Brett Kirk, one of the most respected players in the game.
He's a genius, Brett Kirk. Well, he is, you know. I mean, to keep Sam Mitchell to nine disposals this stage of the game, it just is almost impossible to do. But he's been doing it week in, week out for about 9 years now, Brett Kirk. They love him so much. He just does the job for his side every week, doesn't he?
He's a beauty, Brett Kirk. And look, Hawthorn at this centre bounce. Stuart Dew, not ideal for the position in at the centre bounce. Ellis is also in there. He's got a tagging job on McVeigh. And just all going Sydney's way at the moment.
Mitchell's only had four disposals since quarter time. He said nine for the match, and the Swans have got the run of play at the moment. Can they capitalise? Goods has a rest. He's been instrumental, 15 disposals and two goals. Hall's back in the goal square, away to the right. Out of camera's reach just for the moment. This is Matner, clever back for McVeigh, who was so prolific in the first half. In fact, he's had only two touches in this, one touch in this second half so far, but 22 for the night. There's Barry and Murphy back in the goal square. Pretty much one-on-one inside the 50 for the Swans at the moment. Mitchell can't quite get there again. And they are just swarming the Hawks. Dew feeling the heat there.
Clearances this quarter, 8-3, Sydney's way.
Lots of pointing going on as they get the setups, or try to get the setups right. Bolton's turn to go up with the ruck work. McVeigh looked around, could only see Hawthorn jumpers and got caught holding the ball. It's a wasted opportunity for them.
Schoenmakers kicks to Franklin. Good effort by Craig Bolton again. What a game he's played on Franklin.
I would think most forwards in the AFL would consider Craig Bolton one of the toughest to play against. He really sees himself as number one, beating his opponent. He's not a kick chaser.
And if outsized by a fair margin too, height-wise, is Bolton against Franklin. Here they go again at it, one-on-one. Franklin again, the front spot, tries to tap it unsuccessfully to Kennedy, and Shaw's away. Kicks to Hall, who's growing in confidence. Couldn't take the mark. Moore chips into a hole. It's all Hawthorn here, and Whitecross will mop up. Handballs to Ellis. He's forced to kick hurriedly. It's Kennedy against Jolly, who should win hands down, and does. Bevan. It's an over to Bird. So Sydney by 11.
Inside 50s, 8-2 for the quarter in favour of Sydney. It was a stat that was being dominated by the Hawks in the first half. They still had more for the match by 3, Hawthorn, but Sydney just getting so much more of it in more meaningful positions in this second half so far. Jared Moore, they've come at him. He has to chip it up high. Will it get through to Jolly? It does, but there's Hawks everywhere. Campbell Brown. This is Young Thorpe. Oh, he almost stubbed his toe, but he got it away okay. Williams has to adapt. Hall pressing, not a good kick. They're starting to fall away at the seams, the Hawks, and the Swans are taking advantage. But they will always give you everything they've got, Hawthorn. Mistakes happening on both sides at the moment. Sure, the pressure cranks up, the running cranks up. Out wide to half forward. Bolton, no, it's not Bolton, it's Young Meredith. Kick smother, we've seen more smothers and fumbles and everything. It's all happening.
Yeah, great bit of play there. And it was set up for me from that man on screen there, Woolsey. The defensive chase Barry Hall put on, second and third effort, gave his team another opportunity. Really well done.
Yeah, and again, Goods dropping back near the goals on the shorter Guerra.
34 of the 36 players in one half of the ground at the moment. That's Sydney's attacking half.
Might have been just the old reverse psychology during the week from Paul Roos, saying, if you don't rate us, we're no good. Come and watch the buddy show. He would have been well aware that his record against Alistair Clarkson is excellent. He's beaten him 5 out of 6 times, and I reckon they were quietly confident about their chances this week.
Another not 15 call from the umpire, Morton. That's it to Bateman. He stood up in the tackle and delivered to Stokes, who puts the foot on the accelerator and goes for home and misses.
I'm just going to ask you, have Sydney made the most of their domination for this passage of play at this stage, do you think?
I think they would ideally like to have put another goal or two on, but a 10-point margin in this game, the way Sydney play, I reckon, is a pretty handy break. 9 minutes to go until three-quarter time. If they could get another goal in front, I reckon they'd go in at three-quarter time, feeling very, very happy with themselves.
McVeigh. Matner makes it pretty tough for Kieran Jack. He was solid, but Schoenmakers has done a couple of nice things tonight. That was one of them. Hawthorn, hard to keep at bay, though, Darcy. I'll always know while Buddy and Franklin and Rioli are around that you're not safe, are you?
Yeah, absolutely. They showed that last week, didn't they? Yeah, it was the Buddy and Ruffy show in the last quarter against Geelong in round one, and they're always dangerous.
Gee, the umpires are hot on interference and stoppages at the moment, the start of a season. Stokes got dragged down. Advantage. And Roughhead kicks the goal. Back to a four-point ball game. He's got 3, so as much as he hasn't had a night out, in fact, last week he kicked 4, I think, from 8 disposals, so he's been pretty efficient.
Did well, Stokes, only a little bloke, but made sure he got in front, full stretch for the mark. The Guerra kick was a beauty. Hard, low, penetrating left footer. And Hawthorn certainly got plenty of players who can do that.
I mentioned it, Rob, they're really clamping down on the interference at the stoppages, which I know they've said that every year, probably for the last 3 years, but we've noticed it tonight. There's the disposals for the match.
And McVeigh and Reece Shaw, look, I think he's been really good for Sydney. His first game last week in the last half against St Kilda, I thought Reece Shaw's just started to settle down in the new colours, and he's been good tonight.
Bateman, no free kick out of that one. Goods up against the young Schoenmakers. Goods with the pace, taps it over to Shaw. And that's silly. That is very silly from Young. Just an easy giveaway free kick.
Now late contact against Clinton Young. Down the ground. Late contact against Clinton Young. Mark's it.
So Meredith's got the footy.
Jolly's pushed deep forward.
Short to Craig Bolton. The Hawks put in that zone and just hold things up a little bit. Kick wasn't great to Richards, but he's got plenty of time to recover, and he'll give it back to Bolton. So the Swans going backwards at the moment, and it's making it look pretty ugly. Now he's painted himself into a corner, and that's poor play by the two Sydney defenders. Roughhead couldn't hang on to the mark, but now he's got the footy. In fact, make it Rioli. Rioli pops it over the top to Stokes. Stokes back to Rioli. Rioli has a shot at goal and misses. Exciting play, though.
How is the turn of speed from standing still to full pace? He gets it in about three strides. Here's Luke Ablett going off and down with the doctor, which is a concern for them. But there he is. He's standing still, and then he gets to top speed so quickly.
So they made a meal of that, those two Sydney defenders, didn't they?
And Rhys Shaw made a meal of that one as well. So the Swans haven't had a great last 5 minutes after looking like they were ready to put the foot down. We're trying to set it up for Buddy, and Hawthorn could be back in front in a moment if they can have some success here. Interference, some high contact. And Kennedy gives to Hodge. And it's all Sydney back there. Should be able to take the mark okay. Jesse White does that. But can they hit the next target? This is where they've had trouble all night. Oh, boy, it's not great either. And it's over and out. It's just been a constant worry for them, hasn't it, trying to get cleanly out of defence?
Well, their last three times they've tried to clear it, they haven't been able to hit target, Sydney. They're hanging in really well, though. They've made a real game of this.
Jude Bolton, toe poke, spills back to a Hawthorn player, Kennedy, to Morton. And he goes long. It's coming back. Just misses. It is the Swans by 2 points.
There's Sam Mitchell on the screen, Rob. I reckon at three-quarter time, Alistair Clarkson will go to him and say, listen, you've only had 9 disposals. You've been beaten by Brett Kirk. And I know at halftime in the grand final, he was the one he singled out. Cameron Ling really did a number on him, particularly in the first half. And I know he's got a lot of pride. He's a superstar player. He'll really want to turn it on in the last quarter because Kirk has done a fantastic job on him.
Yeah, he looks listless to me, Luke. And he hasn't been in and under at a lot of centre bounces. They've played him in the forward line a fair bit.
And there's Kirk saying, get me back on. I don't want him to get a touch while I'm off the ground. I want to get back on.
Well, Jude Bolton's got the job on Mitchell at the moment. But he just doesn't seem right to me, Sam Mitchell. Usually he's in and under. And look at this. I want to get on. I want to get him. I've had control over him the last 2 quarters.
A lot of players don't feel well when they play on Brett Kirk for some reason.
Another possession to McVeigh, although an ineffective one, and Morton ran out of room there.
And Bolton coming off, and we'll watch Kirk come on. I know where he'll go. Straight to the shoulder of Mitchell.
White rips it out of the arms of Kennedy.
We'll just keep an eye on Brett Kirk, encouraging his teammate. Look at the voice. Look at the voice. Non-stop.
White the tap to Kirk. He ran into a wall.
So there's been lots of little niggles for Hawthorn tonight, and you take into account last week's big game against Geelong. It's going to be interesting to see what they've got left in the last quarter. Swans have got a few little injuries of their own, of course, as we've noticed.
Here's Goods. Gives it to Crouch.
So is that not a case where it could be 50 for Goods, or that's a different rule?
I was looking further up the ground, though. I'd have to see the replay of that one, to be honest with you. But
he was dumped in the back. I think the umpire maybe said it was in the back rather than dumped after he got rid of it. So hence it's not 50.
Goods to O'Keefe.
You've got him first.
This will be just his fifth possession for the ninth quarter, Ryan O'Keefe.
He's had a very quiet night.
Jolly wants this long. If he can get it over the back, over the top of Hodge, he's going to have a crack at it.
Brown not happy with that free kick either. Hall works his way to the front. Moore squeezes the kick out. It's going to be a goal.
Sydney Swans know they've got the advantage up in their forward line with the height there. Barry Hall, almost the mark, maybe a free kick, doesn't matter. Kirk, the first one underneath it, ends up in the hands of Moore. Now have a look at this. They have got Jolly in the goal square. Barry Hall's down there. O'Keefe's come into it in this third term.
Mitchell gets the clearance. Roberts, Thompson, got back to take it.
Even that, Sam Mitchell is one of the most composed players in the AFL.
He's 50 there, sorry to interrupt.
Yeah, 50 there, but it's the perceived pressure of Brett Kirk. He grabbed that footy in 10 metres of space, panicked with the kick and turned it over. Brett Kirk gets inside your head.
Luke Hodge is Jolly's opponent at the moment. Jolly in the goal square.
Gloomy look in the box for the Hawks. Goods just adjusted the kick, hoping for Hall. There's some pushing there, and it's a Sydney free.
They're nervous when the ball's in the air because they're undersized. No Crowe, no Gillam. And that's why Paul Roos has put Jolly down there for a while, because along with Barry Hall, Goods has played deep forward a lot in this quarter. And it's just trying to expose and exploit that young Hawthorn defence.
Jolly coming off. Didn't look like he wanted to come off. He was asking the question, I think, is why. And O'Keefe makes it really hurt now. It's out to 14.
Headaches are plenty for Alistair Clarkson and his Brains Trust. Very big 4 minutes coming up in this match as Jolly has a breather. But Sydney out to a 14-point buffer. White in the ruck. That could be in the back to Sydney. No. Well, they go back inside attacking 50. Again, it's a high ball inside. Goods does the roving. Birchall jumped on top. Now he releases it.
There's a massive difference in possessions between the two sides now, isn't it? Sydney 262, Hawthorn 193.
Thorpe in the ruck. White comfortably. Straight though to Jew.
Gee, I love watching Brett Kirk. He's up and about. He's on his toes. He's talking. He's proactive. And he'll always make contact with Mitchell.
Ablett back on the ground. Good to see. Third man up. Locked it inside 50. Young. Broke the tackle on the right boot. Not a bad kick. Rioli against Bevan. Rioli, can he trap it? Ruffhead comes in to lend a helping hand. He'll give it back to Rioli, who works his way inside 50. He's on his wrong side. He twists, he turns, he dodges. Keeps it alive. Moss can go all the way himself on the left boot. Kicks a vital goal for the Hawks. Well played, Rioli. Big goal to Moss. It was all set up by the run and carry from Surioli with a little help from Ruffhead.
Big call this, but he's almost the best one-on-one player in the competition. Quarters, he causes small defenders more trouble than just about anyone else. He never falls over. He's fantastic in the air, and his speed at ground level. Crouch, who I can't get his name out, is a very, very good defender and quick. He is all at sea one-on-one with Surioli. He's so dangerous, and he's keeping his side in at the moment. I would be trying to get him as many one-on-one opportunities as he can.
First goal in league footy to Gary Moss.
Just his second game. Adam Goods having a rest. They're all going to be storing up their energy for the last quarter, but there's still a bit of time left in this term, 3.5 minutes, and the Hawks can do so much damage so quickly. Mark Pade. Point I made before, with Rioli there, and obviously Franklin and Ruffhead, you just can't count Hawthorn out.
Well, I think last week, Hutto, against the Cats, it was Ruffhead and Franklin who got six goals between them.
And the game looked shot, didn't it? Geelong were dominating, but Hawthorn came at them. So Sydney will be well aware of that. That's not a great kick from Bolton to the wing. Just a bit of hesitation there. Bird did well in the end. He's able to clear the path. Meredith can approach the 50 as he swings around. Gets himself into trouble, but smartly gets himself out of trouble. Malcheski lets fly. Is it good enough for his third goal? You bet it is. And there's a bit of joy and love in the air tonight for the Sydney fans.
And well done by young Meredith. Cuts on his right and just provides some space for Malcheski to run into, and Malcheski's confidence sky high. Kicked a couple from set shots earlier in the game. That one on the run from the boundary.
Well into red time in the third quarter. It's the Swans by 14. Malcheski with three goals. Finished beautifully there. White won it against Thorpe. There's Bird. Got it to Kirk. Bangs it inside 50. Meredith dropped the mark. Keefe almost snaffled it. Moore to Ablett. One-on-one, Hall with the strength. He's got it! Too strong for Murphy.
And that's why Paul Roos has had Barry Hall down there in the goal square pretty much by himself for most of this third quarter.
So this to make it 20 points. Barry Hall looking for his fourth. No problem there. The Swans have a firm grip on this match now.
Yeah, an experienced defender, Thomas Murphy, and had the support last year of Trent Crowder, who has been an All-Australian defender. Stephen Gillen's an improved player, so they're exposed a bit today. Maybe a bit lucky there, Barry Hall. If you have a look at that replay, yeah, he had a fair chunk of the jumper, but the strength of Barry, that long ball in, there's the contested marks for the game. That's a massive stat, 14-2.
Just a reflection of the strength and height advantage they have, isn't it, really?
Absolutely.
So, out to 20. There's a long way to go, Stephen, in this game. But the Swans have had a big third quarter. White up high, got the tap down again. There's Hodge trying to lend some inspiration in the centre. But Mr. Inspiration, Brett Kirk, not having a bar of it. Sends it out to the wing. Whitecross has done a wonderful job, but he just couldn't hold his footing that time against O'Keefe. Ablett, scrappy. McVeigh. Meredith left it behind. He really didn't get any good delivery. Apologies comes from Mark McVeigh's brother, Jared. As we get the throw in.
That's unusual, Hutto. Sam Mitchell playing in a back pocket.
60 metres around from goal then. White down for Bolton. They're really winning around the edges of the packs, aren't they? Bird to make it 26. Hall again, another chapter in his battle of strength and will with Murphy.
Hutto, another easy hit out to Sydney, 57-20.
Who said Ruckman don't make any difference, was he?
Well, that's right.
It was a dead set push in the back. It wasn't down in front of us on thought. The umpire didn't see it. And the Swans will be able to go forward.
Bird has it again.
Get the shakes when Sydney do this.
Well, they mucked it up last time, but
hit outs for the quarter, 27-6.
Get nervous when Cyril Rioli's around too in this situation.
Kirk's on deep, but I don't see.
Crouch to Richards back in the centre square. Sydney by 21. Marks in this quarter, 32-5, Sydney's way.
Players look over the scoreboard and say there's 36 minutes gone in the term, so no wonder they think the siren's going to ring.
We haven't had a lot of goals either, have we?
A few.
Oh, I'll take that back, we've had 12. There might be another one here too, as Hall couldn't take the mark. There's the siren. And what a quarter from the Swans. In that quarter, they kicked 8 goals to Hawthorn's 4. And that's why the quarter went 402 minutes.
That sounds like a Hawthorn supporter to me.
How to count the Hawthorn goals quarters. It was very, very entertaining third term. Sydney were fantastic. There's Brett Kirk on screen, the skipper, who has done a phenomenal job on Sam Mitchell. Hawthorn aren't out of this. The two big guns kicked lots of goals last week. Make sure you stay tuned for the last quarter.
Well, can Franklin put on a show? It'd have to be one hell of a show. They trail by 21 points, Luke.
There's Sam Mitchell on the wing. They've started him out to try and get him away from Brett Kirk. He's the captain of the side. He's had no impact in this game. I bet you the coach has said to him, we really need a big last quarter from you.
Hodge into the middle as the last quarter starts. As good as Hawthorn are, no one likes to start the season with two losses.
I reckon Kirk will try and find him now, Woolsey. Starting on the wing, Kirk was looking for him and he's trying to get to him already. There he is.
Yeah. And Roughhead in the ruck. And that's something that you really don't want to see. Hodge got Renoff just can't do it by himself.
Hodge, a couple of influences on play there. And his kick, though, is straight for Bolton. Swans need to work hard leading up the ground to provide options out of defence, and Meredith comes to the party.
Pretty good debut by this kid.
Well, it was interesting what Paul Roos, and he said it during the week as well, he said to you pre-game, Rob, they actually want to play some more kids, but they're injured. And Meredith was good in the reserves last week for Sydney in the Canberra League, and they're giving him the chance, and I think Sydney fans have been crying out for that for a little while now to see some of the youth blooded. been a good start. There's Franklin, he's, as we touched on throughout the night. It's been a quiet night for him so far. Just five disposals and one goal too. Jared McVeigh.
And this is a worry. Renoff is now playing at full back on Barry Hall.
Well, probably, at least he's got a bit more size, hasn't he, than Murphy, but he's got no experience as a defender.
No, if they can get the ball often enough to Barry Hall, I think you're leading.
And he'll be fairly fatigued, Wolsey, from the amount of minutes he's played in the ruck.
Absolutely.
I reckon he'll float right up. Big ask for him tonight to hold down the ruck and then go and play on one of the guns in the competition.
Jolly to Kirk with slick stuff. Jack, he's got 360, so he's gone.
See, Luke Hodges got that sense, hasn't he, that the game's on the line. I'm the man that's going to stand up for my side.
He kicks to Rioli. He gets it moving quickly. To Bateman. Not a lot on offer. Ellis. The Hawks try and run it out. They've moved it well there. Moss, a long ball, looking for Franklin. Oh, he got it on the second bite. So Franklin directly in front, only 35 metres out.
Just his third mark of the game, buddy.
And it wasn't an overly confident one, was it? He got there in the end. So a must kick goal for the Hawks. And it's through the middle. It's back to 15, the difference.
Well, they've got a lot less ground to make up than they did last week.
And interesting this, Luke. Now we see Hodge moved in at the centre bounce. He's been in the back line. He's gone forward after he copped that knock to the back of the head. McVeigh looks as if he's going to tag him pretty tightly.
Roughhead actually got the tap down. It didn't do much good, though. Bolton thrusting it forward desperately. Brown ducked the head into it. That's the way the umpire reads it. White cross did well. Good run from Renouf coming out of defence. Hall got some attention from Brown. Good to Hard Shepherd. Keeping his feet. Grundy been good tonight. Sets it up. That's not a great kick. Can Goods get involved? He's got the free. He's got the free. Boy. Goods was in the air and couldn't do much.
Barry Hall from that chase stand just got up a little bit gingerly. We'll get Corey to keep a bit of an eye on him. Like he pulled up, saw the trainer's gone straight out to him.
Here's a look at it. Was it a free to Goods? Against Birchall, you'd have to say that's what free was for, but gee, a lot of contact. Now it comes down to Adam Goods at one end. We saw Buddy Franklin kick truly. Same spot, same result at the other. Adam Goods is up to the moment. It's back to 21.
Ran off at full back. He got the kick, but it was a bad kick, and Sydney were able to rebound and goal.
Bit of a sore shoulder for Hall, but he's got plenty of muscle on him, so he'll be right. It's a free kick going the Swans' way. As we're taken by McVeigh. He gets it moving quickly to Shaw.
And Goods bolting forward.
Yep, and he's got the sit here against Jew. Oh, it's a free kick to Goods for Shepherding, surely. Has to be.
Barry Hall coming off.
Corey Wingard.
Yeah, I think it might be a knee, boys. He's just started on a lead there, and then he just waved his hands and said, no, I'm no good. He was flexing the right knee while he's standing in that goal square, so he's either got a knock to the knee or maybe a little strain there.
Gee, he worked hard to get up into the forward 50, Adam Goods. He was in at that centre bounce. It was a free kick to Sydney, and he just bolted forward.
Goods has had a great night. This for his fourth.
Let me move it up the leg a little bit. I said knee. It's more groin they're working on. He's been shaking the leg off, trying to shake it out, but the groin looks like it's going to get a bit of attention there. Pulled his tights up and going to give him a rub, and he's just having a sit on the bench now.
All right, so it's out to 27. Still early stages of this last quarter. They are up and about, though, the Swans. Goods, Bevan, great chain of handballs. Matner zooming through Hawthorn. Long and strong. It's wide. Let it go. Let it go. The damage is done. It's beyond five goals. The reigning premiers could be on their way to consecutive losses at the start of the season.
And again, it all came from the centre bounce. There wasn't even a contest by Roughhead. And it was just so easy. Have a look there. Jolly to Goods. And away they go. Not even a contest in at that centre bounce. And they have been absolutely flogged in the ruck tonight, Hawthorn.
The Swans, 6 goals, 3 from centre clearances tonight. And they're out to 33 points in front. So Roughhead, Jolly with ease, knocks it forward again. And he follows up his good work with a soccer off the ground. McVeigh, who's had 29 touches. It's Roughhead, taken by Jude Bolton. Kurt squeezed the kick out. Goods, beautiful use of the body. Kennedy to Brown. He's all wrapped up. We'll have a bounce right on Sydney's 50. There's Barry Hall watching on. He's kicked 4 goals, 2 tonight. Having a chat to Paul Roos. Kennedy to Young on his wrong side. It's come off okay as the mark's taken by Franklin. He's a long way from home. He kicks long. Rioli weaves some magic here. Williams, who started the game so well. Great tackle. Got it back to Rioli, but not for long as the Swans strip him of the ball. And Sydney out of danger. Well played as Reece Shaw takes the mark. And he's off.
And out to the wing where Jolly's lurking there. Not much on for him straight away. Margin 33 points. It's going to be hard to decide who's the best player on the ground tonight.
Oh, he's got a big call for the telly tonight. Jolly's, I think I know who's going to get it.
Well, I don't want to influence the Wolsey, but I reckon Brett Kirk's got to be right up, featured pretty prominently as well.
I reckon the ruckman might be considered, although do you take into account that he hasn't had as much opposition as normal, Rob?
No.
Okay, I think that tells us who's going to win it, doesn't it? Here's Buddy. We need a little bit of Buddy magic in the last quarter. Young unloads. Couldn't get any direction. Plenty of distance out on the full. And the Sydney crowd, 33,000 here tonight. So better than they got in the at final. It's North Melbourne in the poor weather last year. Buddy was the focus of the pre-match promotion, of course, and hasn't been able to live up to the top billing tonight. Here's Chance Bateman. Just chipping ball, hoping. And they might get a free out of this, the Hawks. Stuart Dew, who's had just 4 touches tonight.
There's the free kick over the shoulder.
Here's Stewie Jew to try and pop it through. Maybe give them a little bit of oxygen to the Hawks. He's done enough, and it's back to 27.
Sydney's lead cut back to 27. First goal for the evening for Stewart Jew. Just the 5 disposals as Hall's still sitting down with a suspect groin or knee. One of the two. Roughhead got the tap and won the footy. Puts Hawthorn back inside 50. The race is on. Richards will get there first. Franklin hot on his heels. Bolton. What a game he's played. Another throw in on Hawthorne's half forward flank.
She won a fair share of the footy, Craig Bolton, as well. He's had 12 marks and 22 disposals. I know when you talk to forwards in the competition, he's the one that they find almost harder than anyone to get a kick on, Craig Bolton.
So let's have a look. Is that the Hall injury?
Yes.
Yeah. The groin there. Over the knee.
Wet ball, throwing it up.
So 50 out from the Hawks' goal. Here's Dew again. From a long way out. Kicks Bolton in front, sees it safely over the line.
There is still time for Hawthorn, Steve. I know.
Yeah, 27 of a couple of quickies.
Yep.
Straight out of guys, eyes up.
So White, uncontested almost in the ruck. Bolton under the pump. And Bevan's happy to see it over the line.
Franklin has to do the ruck work. Jesse White gives him a little nudge. And lovely palming work. Now it's Moore that has to ride the Bateman bump. Bird finds a path through. Bolton's, Jude and Craig combine. And then Luke Ablett kicks crisply to the wing. No interference from Murphy on O'Keefe. And Goods takes full advantage. Sends it in deep and strong to the man that's caused such a headache all night. And Darren Jolly uses those extra centimetres to advantage again.
Not sure if he's got a flat screen TV in his hand.
He might get two tonight.
Well, yeah, I reckon that's just kept it off. He has been fantastic right from the start.
Good kick, isn't it?
And Robert's going to make Simon Taylor install them.
Well, he's had a wonderful night. He's had 40 hit-outs. He's earned 10 contested balls, which is as much as anybody has on the night.
You don't have to justify yourself, Wolsey.
And there he's kicked a beautiful off-the-boot goal. Darren Jolly's laughing because of the kick. That is just an absolute mongrel punt. And he can't believe that it's gone straight. It did go straight. It didn't spin off the boot. But he'll take it. He's had a wonderful night.
Players actually in the warm-up at training, when you're mucking around, you try and kick them finger breakers at each other, and they're not easy to mark or easy to kick, but they very rarely go as straight as that. And he's still laughing about it, Darren Jolly. Can't believe that went through.
The old kick to kick, I reckon the modern footballers wouldn't know anything about it, would they? Training kick to kick?
Oh, I don't know about that. I reckon still warm up with a bit of a kick court. It's probably going to take the hanger like you used to in the schoolyard, but certainly got to kick the footy a lot.
Young to Franklin. He kicks to Morton. That's a free kick. Made him earn it.
Well, I think it's Jesse White, isn't it, who hit him, and he's one big unit. Have a look at him.
Nice shiner too.
Like the way he moves, Wolsey. Look, he hasn't got a lot of the footy, but that's a good effort. And that's what you want from your big man, to commit your body. He's got a basketball background. He's athletic. And
One more. That's it there. Thank you.
Good on him.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good on him. Just pile drive the opponent into the ground. Good on him. I like the boy.
That's 20.
So Jared Morton, one goal, two next to his name tonight. From about 40 out. And that's a nice finish.
So Sydney led by 27 points, and presuming that they do go on and win this game, and there's still maybe a little bit of time, what do we learn about their future with Brisbane, Carlton, Frio, and Richmond to come? All matches, they should be pretty competitive, you know, I would have thought.
They'd be pretty happy with the way that Barry Hall's played. I know he's off injured, so I hope it's not too bad. But I thought he was good up for it. Adam Goods was sensational. Craig Bolton in the back line's been really good. Reece Shaw settling into his new club. Kirk had a job on Sam Mitchell and has done it to perfection.
There's Bird at the back of the pack. Almost stymied his captain in Brett Kirk.
Got to remember... two really big late omissions today for Hawthorn. To take Brad Sewell and Robbie Campbell out of the side. We know the effect that's had on the ruck division, and Brad Sewell was one of their first picked, and been hard for them to cover that tonight.
8 premiership players from last year not on the ground tonight.
White down and Stokes grabbed it. I think there's 11 Sydney players out there that are premiership players tonight. So still 10 minutes to go in the quarter. Just bobbling around. Maybe there's some high contact there on Bateman. Apparently not. Kirk, Mitchell, all in there scrapping for it. I was surprised he didn't seem too enthusiastic about things at the moment. And off and wide. He's getting good, valuable time. They're right now, Buddy Franklin. Lays it off nicely, Kennedy. This is Moss again. He popped up for a nice goal early. Stokes with a bit of a run-up. Couldn't take advantage. Moss just gets ridden there. And we're going to have a ball up. Michael Watson will be a handy inclusion for them when he comes back.
Being spotted on the screen, gets a big cheer.
Buddy's circling around here, just waiting to see if he can get his hands on the footy. White denies him. McVeigh, Crouch. Swans up to the wing. O'Keefe comes to meet it. Malcheski got there first. Brown uses Birchall, who dangerously gives a big chance for Goulds, who can't quite seduce the ball in, but it's still bubbling around, and now it's a Sydney free.
Bevan's going to get it. Committed his body really well then. Played 42 consecutive games for Sydney now, Paul Bevan, as Darren Jolly comes back on. Been a great effort from them tonight.
Margin stands at 27. Bevan just away to the right.
So Renoff marks deep in defence. It's the Swans by 28, and that's a tied kick. From Brent Renoff.
Just keep an eye on Sam Mitchell. No disposals in this final quarter. Just 11 for the game as a midfielder. I hope there is something wrong with him because he's certainly not working hard and running hard out there.
Handball. Kennedy loses possession. In there is Mattner working hard.
No chance.
So anyone here tip the Swans tonight?
No.
No. Hutto?
I thought they were...
Did you tip them, though? Don't give me... I thought. Did you tip them or not?
I did before the game. So no, I didn't during the week. Oh, you asked the question, didn't I, Luke? Be my witness.
You said you thought they were a chance. Oh. I don't know whether you declared them.
I think the word's dead set certainty. Mentioned somewhere.
Just another free kick. This will be a great learning experience for Renoff.
And good kick, clever kick. And is there a 50-metre penalty here? Umpire says no.
It was a nice kick by the ruckman.
Yeah, it was clever, wasn't it? Well weighted.
It was. He meant to find him there. Look at that. Just pulled the kick.
So Brett Kirk, who's done a fabulous job on
look
Sam
at
Mitchell.
Malcheski's hanging around him saying, handball it to me because you're not much much of a kick. He's got about three teammates hanging around him.
Well, he's kicked 76 goals in his 197 matches. Yeah, a bit of icing on his cake tonight. He's had a great night. Oh, no, never in doubt. Another goal for the Swans. They're home.
Brett Kirk kicked that last goal. This is the reaction. Means a lot to him. The heart and soul of this football club.
The win tonight means a lot to them, I reckon, doesn't it, Rob? 34 points they're in front by. They're against the reigning premier, even though they're underdone and they've had some injuries, Hawthorn, given what Sydney went through last week.
Oh, look, they copped it last week and they had a couple of quarters where they didn't kick a goal and would have been a long week for them, but they've bounced back really well, and that's the beauty of football, isn't it? You know, Richmond, they gave a really honest effort today, and all the talk was about them last week. And all the players want to do after a bad one is get out there.
Dew gets them in there. Mitch Thorpe. Good blind turn from Moss. He's done a couple of nice things tonight. He's had 12 disposals.
No goals in the second and third quarters last week for Sydney. 13 tonight, Rob.
Yeah, no, they've been really good. They've been really good. They got a sniff, I think, early in the game. And the confidence just grew and grew. They had the players up forward worrying that skinny, inexperienced Hawthorn defence. Oh, we've said it 1,000 times. They've dominated the ruck.
Another armchair right there, but they've turned it over and given Stuart Dew an opportunity, which he's blown. And the margin now stands at 33 points.
I think the AFL would be really pleased to see a Sydney win against the Hawks.
Why?
Because a lot of people think that this Sydney team's an old team and they're on the wane, and that the second team coming in a few years' time, West Sydney, that you do need the Swans to be up there and about. you don't want them to fall completely away. Otherwise, the knockers will say, why would you bring a second team into Sydney? It'll happen.
The first game of Meredith got it to Malcheski, who's taken for a ride.
Had 11 touches of the footy, Brett Meredith. Hasn't dominated by any stretch, but he's shown enough that...
50 metres for hanging onto the ball too long and not speaking nicely to the umpire.
Very good 50. Well, more like about 70. I reckon it's 75.
Mate, you got to give it straight back to him. Huh? Must give it straight back to him.
You might as well just abuse him one more time. Get another 50.
Mate, I'm not silly.
He's not silly.
So Luke Hodge has been in the wars tonight with a heavy head knock. Misses. Oh, it's turned into a dirty night for the Hawks.
Look through their major ball winners for the night quarter. Xavier Ellis has had the most with 19, and then Josh Kennedy at 15.
Yeah, four kicks, 11 handballs.
Yeah, it's not a lot, is
not
it?
A lot.
Normally you've got Mitchell up there with 30 plus.
Well, they've had Luke 100, almost 100 disposals more, Sydney, for the night.
Just haven't had the footy at all, have they?
Well, no Sewell, no Lewis.
Yeah, they got a lot to come back. Wouldn't be worried if I was you, Stephen.
I'm not worried at all. No, just calling it as I see it. Independent commentator. Don't you start.
Jeez. 21-10 to 15-14.
Another hitter.
John. I haven't mentioned Simon Taylor for a while. Rob. Margin 32 here. Last 5 minutes to go in this game. All right, Bozzo. Here's another hit out.
Holding on to Cyril Rioli, holding him. The guards around him, stopping him from running. Cyril, your kick.
That's all the explanation you need. Cyril Rioli has been ever present tonight, just 13 disposals, but...
Jared Crouch gets penalised for holding.
Thanks, mate. That's the line marks there.
It's hard to be a tagger in the early rounds of the year, I think. The stoppages.
Definitely more of a focus on it this year, and I don't think that's a bad thing.
Here's Rioli. Sprays it. 25-19 last year in his debut season, did Rioli.
No, you grab the ball before he signaled. Okay, so you
tonight,
to
one goal, two.
How'd you go and get another one, mate? Take it back. You grab the footy before he signaled it. You can't do that. Go and grab another footy.
Got to go and grab another footy.
This is the thing. That's ridiculous.
Just kick the thing. Goodness sake.
He grabbed the same one.
He the same that is great.
Not the hit. Why did you need to get another football?
The school teacher mentality, isn't it? Get another one. Can't use that one.
Ablett bundled over the line. No, he kept it alive somehow. Goods got it to Jude Bolton. Now Jolly in front. Another mark.
50.
And 50 against Renoff.
Could be his third goal.
No doubt about the 50. Not very subtle. So Jolly has kicked a couple.
Campbell.
17 disposals for the night. 6 marks.
There's the Hawks next month of footy with North Melbourne, Port Adelaide, and the Adelaide Crows in the next 3 weeks. 37 points the margin. Ablett able to ride the bump.
Let him go now. Stay out, pal.
An emotional week for the Ablett family. He's Jolly. Setting it up to full forward. Someone going to spring out of that. Oh, Jesse White.
A free kick against. Hands in the back. Oh.
Luke.
was a my decision. I think it was a push, though. But
so what? Come on, late in the game.
Yeah, he just gave him a bit of a shove with his hands. He learned not to do that. He didn't have to. But I like him. I reckon he's got some real potential.
Now, back on the wing. Here's Gary Moss. Oh, well done, Roberts. Thompson used the initiative there, went to the front, went and grabbed the footy and puts it on the chest of the young boy Meredith. That's about where it stops. Because the Hawks have got their zone out.
Jolly screaming for it because he's got the height advantage.
He did have until Renoff came along. O'Keefe, it's sneaky there. Somehow got through. Not fit, not far enough, I think the umpire called. Poor Bevan. Doesn't take too many marks inside 50. And the umpire wouldn't give him any joy there at all. Almost a smother on the last line. In fact, a partial smother. And that opens the avenue up for McVeigh. And he was just a little too clever. 38 points is the margin.
A short one from Guerra. Finds Whitecross. Goes back into the corridor. Taken by Kennedy. Long ball to the wing. No free kick. Yes, eventually it was forthcoming.
He attacks the footy hard.
He was good, wasn't he?
He does. He just keeps his eye on it. He's physical and goes about it in a really good manner, Jesse White.
Looks like he likes a scrap. Back to Roberts Thompson, who's also playing his 100th game tonight, along with Williams from the Hawks. Roughhead just sees it safely over the line. Now, here's a stat for you, Rob. The record hit-outs by a team in a match is 66, Sydney against Geelong. We have a new record, 71. The most hit-outs by a team in a game on record.
Ever?
Yep.
Well, doesn't surprise me.
Swans away. Bird inside 58. Keith bounced off the chest, but he has time to recover. Now kicks a long ball deep into the pocket and hits the behind post. So we'll have a throw in.
Stay back.
I'd get a bet on the television, I reckon. I got a fair idea where that's going. Adam Goods has been brilliant tonight.
Four goals for Goods. Three for Melcheski and four for Hall. Sorry, Paul.
Good tap to Moore, but got bowled over. Stokes to Hodge. Now Rioli. So the Hawks work it out of defence. Franklin takes the mark. Plays on straight away. Gives it back to the run of Rioli. Nothing on offer, so he has to stop. Now he tries to find Roughhead. He's got Roberts Thompson snapping at his heels, but the Swans just pounce. Three of them. They've hunted in numbers all night in defence. That's one of the reasons they've won tonight.
And I think Paul Roos and his coaching staff will be well satisfied after a pretty dismal opening round. They've bounced back particularly well. A lot of really good signs for them. And against, the reigning premiers.
Another long quarter.
Stay there.
I'm not going to say anything. It's a late finish tonight, isn't it? 10 o'clock already. Timekeeper's been very generous. And a mark inside 50 for the Hawks. And it's taken by Moss. Playing his second game tonight, he was one of the late inclusions.
He's looked okay too, hasn't he? 15 disposals, kicked a goal.
And he's going to have a crack here. He's already kicked a goal on the match. No, decides against it, does the unselfish thing, looks for the fly of Roughhead, no mark. And again, it was a three-on-one contest and the Swans come away. Roughhead's heard someone from going for that mark. There's the side, it was Crouch, who paid the price, he got crushed by Roughhead. But it's a game over and a very impressive performance from the Sydney Swans, who need to towel up the Hawks by 38.
And well done to Sydney. Yeah, look, very, very good by Sydney. Their supporters, they're happy. The first time they've seen them home here in Sydney. In Meredith on debut, very good. Barry Hall, good up forward. Adam Goods, they dominated the ruck. Their back line was good. Roberts Thompson playing his 100th game. Craig Bolton did the job on Buddy Franklin. Malcheski up forward, he was lively. McVeigh, he's a much improved player, getting plenty of the ball. Reece Shaw across halfback, 26 disposals. And so it went. I think the further the game went, the higher their confidence became. You look at them, they're pretty happy about that. And well done to Paul Roos.
Down to Corey Wingard.
Yeah, have Craig Bolton with me. Craig, that's a great result. Given the first round, coming up against the reigning premiers, how was the build-up for the side, knowing the task ahead, and you on Buddy as well, the match-up there?
Yeah, obviously a very tough task for us tonight. The quality side and playing up here, we had a bit of a point to prove. We didn't have many people back us in, so we're always confident putting in a good show, and it was just a really good performance across the board tonight.
It was the cluster versus the man-on-man, of course, and the man-on-man style won out for you guys. Was it just persistence that made that happen?
Yeah, I think it was just a credit to the boys in the midfield especially. I mean, they're a class side, Hawthorn, and they're so disciplined, and we had to match them in that area tonight. And the pressure over the field is fantastic and certainly made our job a lot easier down back.
Talk about the captain, Brett Kirk, too, because he seems to lead that midfield so, so well. He did a great job again tonight, and he really just did keep them ticking.
Yeah, he just keeps going, Kirk. He's getting better. It was like a good line. I think he's pushing 36 now, and he's just getting better every year. So it's
true. Great job, mate. Go and celebrate with the boys. Back to you, quarters.
Bit unkind there to his skipper, 36. Brett Kirk is actually 32, but what a night he had. Barry Hall did his job, went off with what appears to be a groin injury, but he certainly contributed well with four goals. The Swans, big winners in the end, 38 points over the reigning premiers.
He's retired, but a lot of experience out of that team, a lot of their midfielders, and they really did do it hard. They got smashed in the ruck, they got smashed in the clearances, and up forward you had Barry Hall and Goods in good form. Jolly played the